Hi guys, this is Jamie from System22 and GreatWebDesign.com. This is a follow-up video to one I made earlier about animating any module in the Divi theme. And I've had a few questions, people asking if you can actually change the transition duration time or the time that it takes to animate a section. And the answer is yes, and I'll show you exactly how. If we go down and I'll animate one of these modules, let's take this module, I'll animate that one. So if we go to the page and edit the page, as you saw in the other video, we just got to add an animation class to it. This has changed slightly since Divi have upgraded this little interface here. It's still very intuitive and good. So we're going to give it the CSS class here of ET animated, ET PB animation right, which should make that animate to the right, that little module we were looking at. Let's try that. Update our page. And preview our changes. Now when we go down there, it should animate, if we refresh, it should animate in from the right. There we go, you see it's animating in. There we go. And what people are asking is, can we slow that down so it does it more slowly? If I do that again, you'll see it sort of goes in quite quickly. I think it takes about a second as the default there. But there we go. And the answer is yes, we just have to go to our custom style sheet. So if we go to the dashboard, down to Divi and theme options to our custom style sheet here, I'll just add it near the bottom of mine. Make a little comment so I can find it easier if I need to edit it at a later date. And what we need to do is give it a class of ET PB animation, right, and the class of ET animated, open curly brackets, close curly brackets. Don't worry about copying the CSS. I'll put a downloadable file of it, PDF file of it, below, a link below this video here, so you can just download it and use it yourself if you need to. Obviously, if you're animating top, put top in there, left and bottom, etc. Just change that right to left, top, bottom, whatever you happen to be wanting to change. Now to change the duration, we want to put in animation duration, funnily enough. So it's dash duration. Make sure I spelt that right. Animation duration. Yep, that looks about right. And I'll give it quite a big time so you can see, let's say 4 seconds, 4s. You can, if you want to do it in milliseconds, that's fine, 4,000, but 4 seconds is 4 seconds. And semicolon afterwards. And save those changes. Now, if we go back to our site and do a refresh, see, it's actually taking it 4 seconds to complete that cycle now. If that's not clear to you, let's put it up to 6 seconds. And back to our page. And another refresh. You see it's going real slow. It's taking its time, basically. So that is how you change the duration time of your CSS animated effect there. It's very easy. Like I say, I'll put this CSS down below in a PDF for you to download and use as you wish. If you want to pause it, if you don't want it to start, let's put that at a reasonable time again now, let's say 2 seconds. If you decide, well, I don't want the animation to actually start for, you know, 2 or 3 seconds after the page loads, it's animation delay. Dash delay. And let's say 5 seconds so we can see it. That's probably no practical use, but it's just an example. And we'll save our changes. Back to our site and refresh. And nothing should happen for 5 seconds or whatever we put in there. 2, 3, 4, 5. Now you see it starts after 5 seconds. But that may or may not be useful to you, but that's how you change the delay duration and also the delay time. There's a bunch of other parameters you can mess with. I've got them all here. Like I say, I'll put this all in the PDF. Use it however you want. Just remember you've got to change the right to left or top and bottom depending on whichever one you're using with your animation. So I hope that's been helpful to you. Once again, this has been Jamie from System22 and Great Web Design. Thanks for watching. Have a great day. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Bye-bye.